Machine learning is probably the most mature subfield in artificial intelligence. It's been used for lots of years, and even sometimes no one called that artificial intelligence, only called that machine learning, because we have lots of different techniques. But what is machine learning? Here is a formal definition that is a study of algorithms and statistical models that computer systems use to effectively perform a specific task without explicit instructions. And this is important. No previous code, no previous instructions to deal a task. And usually machine learning starts with sample data, that we call training data, and use that to build a new model to make some new decisions without explicitly programmed. But let me see with some examples to better understand that. Comparing machine learning with traditional programming. Yes, in a traditional programming area, what we have? Someone has a problem, a difficulty, and defines some rules how to deal with that. And a software engineer put that rules in a programming language and create a code. Yes, and then that code is used maybe in production side to get new data, process the code on top of this new data, and produce an output. Yes, everything at the end was written by the software engineer, and the code is there. The data during the development phase, they only are important to test if the code is okay, but nothing was included with the data in the code. In machine learning, it's not the same thing. The way that you start with training data, you choose a machine learning engineer, choose a learning algorithm, because they are different techniques to use machine learning, use a kind of learning algorithm, and that algorithm on top of the training data built in fact a model. And that model, we can think, what is the model? Model is in fact a kind of code, a code with parameters, with mathematical equations, but this is the code. Then, as you can see, was not the developer that built that code. In fact, the code was built by a learning algorithm on top of training data, but the machine learning is the one that chose the kind of learning algorithm. And then when you move that model to production, what you have? You use new data, input data, on top of this new this model. This model will deal with this new data and will produce an output. Then you see the difference between traditional programming, which a software engineer write all the code, and machine learning, when in fact a machine learning engineer choose a kind of learning algorithm that learns on top of the training data and builds a new model, and that model is used in new data in production. Another difference that we can present to you to see what's the difference between traditional programming and machine learning? As I said, traditional programming is very good to deal with numbers, yes? If you have, for example, you are filling a form in a web page and you have to put your account number, then numbers, yes, for your account banking, for your banking account, yes? In a bank, for example, you have a database with that number as the account base. Then if you want to compare these two information, A and B, the data that you type in the web field or the data that are in the database, both are numbers, it's very easy. It's just an if clause, A equal B. If A equal B, if both numbers are the same, you will have an answer, okay, the account number is correct. But if they are not the same, one of the number are different, for example, the answer will be the account number is wrong. Easy determined is everything like that. Or it is equal or is not equal. In machine learning world, it's not the same. Imagine that you have a situation that the data is not numbers, the data is a picture, and you take a picture in your smartphone, and you have an application that you want to compare with the picture that you have previously taken and is stored in a picture database. The results of a machine learning model will be, if you compare both pictures, it's not that right or wrong. Is the probability that the picture that you have just taken in your smartphone compared with the picture that is in the database, there is a probability that both are equal. In this case, 87% that both pictures are the same. And then your if clause, in fact, will be if the probability of this picture are greater or equal, a threshold that you define it, in this case 85%, then we can say that, okay, this is the guy, welcome back. Or not, this is not the guy, because the probability is less than 85% that this is not the same guy in both pictures, okay? Then, oh, okay, this is an unknown customer. This is very different because the world of machine learning is a probabilistic world, and the world of traditional programming is more determined, is deterministic. It's very different, and if you want to really go deeper in machine learning, you have to learn how to take decisions on top of probabilities and not on top of things that are straight, black or white. In the world of machine learning, things usually have a probability associated to it.